Hello friends. In this practical video tutorial, I will talk about creating and using binary sensors of the times of the day, platform, and the Home Assistant smart home management system. These sensors change their state depending on the time of day. This enhances convenience when creating automations whose launch or actions depend on the current time. I will also show an example of a template for creating a template sensor with similar functionality, changing state depending on the time of day, but with the ability to set a time interval online through the interface. Before we start, please like this video so that it can reach more people interested in the topic of smart home, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. At the time of filming this lesson, the current version of Home Assistant is 2023.12.0. The Times of the Day platform appeared several years ago, and since then there have been no functional changes, apart from the ability to create sensors through the constructor. First, let's look at creating a sensor through the interface. For this, we go to the Settings, Devices and Services menu. Here we need the Helpers tab, it's still empty on this server. In the bottom right corner, we press the button to create a new object. And here we look for the object called Time of Day. This is the binary sensor we need. In the open window, there is a template for creating a new sensor. There are three fields, the name of the object, the start time, and the end time of its operation. Depending on the set localization and time format, there can be either a 12 or 24-hour input format. But this does not change the essence. I created a sensor named Day, which will have the status on starting from 9 in the morning until 9 in the evening. This is the same sensor, but in the 24-hour time format display mode. An important point, after creating the sensor, the time interval cannot be changed anymore. Done, the sensor is created. With this method, it immediately becomes available for use, no need to reload anything. The current time now corresponds to the interval specified in the sensor, so it is active. Now I'll show manual creation in the form of code. This is convenient, for example, when you use packages, as in this example. It allows you to have all objects and automations in one file, in which the logic of a specific case is described. It is declared in the binary sensor section. Specify the platform. TOD, short for times of the day, specify the name and a unique identifier. I usually assign the same as the name. Then specify the start and end time of operation. I set the interval from 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. and the transition between days works. In this case, there is some inconvenience as this integration cannot be reloaded separately in the developer menu, including through the item, the entire YAML configuration. Therefore, after adding, changing, or deleting such sensors in the code, you need to reload Home Assistant. Here are both sensors in the interface. Day, created through the constructor, is on, and night, is currently off, as the current time does not fall within the specified interval. When creating manually, you can specify not only a specific time, but also use variable values, sunset and sunrise, including with the time offset. This sensor will turn on after sunrise and turn off an hour before sunset, as specified in the offset parameter. The minus sign means that this time is before the event, without a minus after. At the moment, the current time falls both in the interval of the first sensor and in the interval of the sensor that works between sunrise and an hour before sunset. For easier understanding, I will use both the constructor and show the code of automations. Let's start with something simple. Turning a light bulb on and off by pressing a button. Here's the code for this automation. When the action sensor, this is a wireless button, receives the status single, which corresponds to a single press, a service is called to toggle the state of the light bulb. If it was off, it will turn on and vice versa. Now let's make it a bit more complex. The trigger remained the same, but instead of the toggle state service and the actions, I added a condition selector and, accordingly, two conditions for the light bulb being off and on. If the light bulb is off at the moment of the trigger, a light on service is started. Unlike the one considered earlier, it has many parameters that can be passed to the lamp. To specify the needed ones, you need to check the checkbox and specify parameters. In this example, I use transition, smooth turning on over 3 seconds. I want the light bulb to turn on in white light mode, so I mark the color temperature option in Kelvin degrees, 4000 for neutral light and brightness and percentage 100. In the second condition, when the light bulb is on, then the light off service will be called. It also has some additional parameters that can be set if necessary. The same in code, the first block that turns on the light with the specified parameters if the light bulb is off. The second block is for turning off the light bulb. Now let's return to the topic of our lesson and apply the time sensors we created. We will further expand the automation we created. Instead of one condition action, the light bulb is off, we will make three. I didn't touch the last action, turning off the light bulb, in this case. The first of the three new condition selector blocks will work when the button is pressed with the light bulb off and the day sensor active, that is, from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. It, like the next two blocks, calls the light on service. And in case we turn on the light bulb during the day, it will turn on with a neutral color temperature and full brightness, 100%. The second block will work in case the light bulb is off and the night sensor is active, that is, from 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. At night, the light bulb will be turned on by the same action, pressing the button, but in a warm light mode with a temperature of 3000 K and a brightness of 30%. Attentive viewers have probably noticed that there are gaps of 2 hours between the sensor intervals, from 7 to 9 a.m. and from 9 to 11 p.m. The third block is created for this. It will work when the button is pressed with the light bulb off and both day and night sensors are inactive, that is, exactly during these 2 hour intervals. For this time, I set some intermediate value, a temperature of 3500 K and a brightness of 70%. I think the principle of using these sensors and automations is clear, with the same trigger. Depending on the time of day, different actions will be launched. This is what it looks like in code. The trigger hasn't changed since the beginning, I only changed the action section. Now there are four blocks here, the first for turning on the light bulb in daylight with maximum brightness. Then the night block with dim warm light, the intermediate block for morning and evening with medium values of temperature and brightness, and the turn-off block. This is just one of many examples. Such sensors can be used not only as conditions but also as triggers for launching automations by time. I have long been using TOTS sensors and various automations, but in some cases, I would like to have the ability to flexibly adjust the time interval without the need to recreate existing sensors. That's why I created a template sensor at one time, which I am sharing with you. You will find the code in a text file. The link is in the description. For entering the time in the interface, I use two input date time objects with the date option disabled, only time. They can also be created in the helpers tab, similarly to how we created the TOTS sensor. However, the code for the template sensor has to be written manually, even if you create it through the constructor. It's all quite simple. Now I will explain in more detail. It's a binary sensor, like TOD, meaning it can have an on or off state. By the way, this is a real sensor that I use in my working configuration. The template consists of several conditions. I have made two separate lessons about the structure of templates. The links are in the description. This condition will work in case the time entered in the first time field, start, is less than the time entered in the stop field, that is, the interval is within 1 day. In such a case, the sensor will be activated when the current time, for which the variable now is responsible with the application of the corresponding format, will be greater than or equal to the start time but less than or equal to the end time. The second condition, when the start time is greater than the end time, that is, the interval goes into the new day. In my case, this is the working state of the sensor, so it's called night time. For correct operation here, it is necessary to consider the transition between days, so there are two matches. The sensor will work when the current time is greater than or equal to the start time, but less than or equal to 23 hours 59 minutes and 59 seconds, that is, until the end of the current day. Or if the current time is greater than or equal to midnight, but less than or equal to the end time. That is, from the beginning of the new day to the time specified in the stop field. The device class is responsible for its display in the interface, but it has no value for the operation of automations. Running. Instead of on or off, it will say working, not working. In order for the sensor to appear in the system after creation, there is no need to reload the entire Home Assistant. It is enough to restart only the input fields of time and date, and then the template objects. Currently, the sensor's time is set from 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. At the time of taking the screenshot, the current time does not fall within this range, so the sensor is not working. And now I changed it to the opposite, from 7 a.m. to 11 p.m., and, accordingly, the sensor is working. The application in automations is similar to what I showed earlier with TOD sensors. Unlike direct time specification in automations, which is available for use both in triggers and conditions, sensors are separate objects that can be displayed in the interface to observe their status. This facilitates the debugging of various automations and allows optimizing them, using the sensor status instead of intervals. They can also be used to create separate, time-dependent templates. In the case of the template time of day sensor, there is the added possibility of changing the time interval directly in the interface. That's all. I hope this lesson was useful and interesting to you. I would be grateful for your likes. They help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and lessons, subscribe to my channel. In the description under the video, you will find a link to the text file with examples shown in the video, other lessons on this topic, as well as my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and group for discussing smart home issues. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to everyone.